this fantastic device. This cool thing. Okay, so what you do with this is you'd actually put it on top of a pot. Not this pot, because there's holes in it. But a normal pot, so... So, say for example, this fits, because this is a little too small. So you put some water in here, so about halfway full. Then you put this on top. And basically you put your veg, whatever you're steaming, in here. And then you steam. So you can obviously then put the lid on top. And that's this one. And then this big one.
So most of your veggies you're going to want to be steaming after the tips that you've given us.
Steam everything. And then this one is just a bigger one. It does the same thing. So same concept, put it in a bigger pot. Have all your veggies in there. Just make sure that the water doesn't touch inside. And then you're good to go. Make sure your water is bubbling, so it has to bubble. And then that's when you know you can start steaming, because then you steam quicker and you don't overcook your stuff. Okay. So, you mentioned chicken and mushrooms earlier. So what you could do with your chicken, if you don't actually have like a griddle pan or anything, you can actually put it on top of like this tray if you want to, and then underneath just make sure that you've got an oven tray that will catch all the juices that fall down. And then with mushrooms, which you can do also if you have those big mushrooms, those portobello mushrooms, you can actually put it on top of here. Again, put your oven dish underneath so it can catch all the juices that fall out. Or if you want, you can make a little bowl out of tin foil and then you can put your mushrooms in there and cook it in the oven. Again, don't overcook it and put a little bit of oil.
So the tray is important, and then obviously the foil is important as well.
This thing.
And it also helps stop cross-contamination?
So the cross-contamination bit, so what you can do is maybe for instance you have your chicken. So you can have your chicken maybe here, and you've got your tray here. And then put something at the bottom that doesn't really need to drip into something. So I would put my broccoli in here, or my mushrooms if you're putting it in a foil bowl. And then again, so put your protein on top, and then your veg at the bottom. Or you can always switch it around. You can put your veg at the top. Maybe if you want to get a little bit of a crisp or char onto your veg, you can put it on top so it gets the direct heat. And then you can just like slowly cook your chicken, whatever, at the bottom.